Hey, it's Chris, and today we're going to be talking about an incredibly productive iPad-only setup featuring the iPad Pro. So this is going to be like inspiration for everybody out there that's already living the iPad-only life, or for people thinking about ditching their laptops or their MacBooks for just an iPad. So there's actually gonna be two parts to this video. Number one is gonna be looking at the individual pieces and components and kind of talking about those. Number two is gonna be more about using this setup and what it's like and how it all works. So I'm gonna be comparing it and drawing conclusions and comparisons based on just the regular iPad Pro with the official Apple keyboard case. So I'm gonna link everything up down in the description, the timestamp, so you can skip around to whatever interests you the most. All right, so let's get into talking about the individual pieces and components. And if you're gonna have a great iPad-only setup, something that's really productive, then you need to turn your iPad basically into a monitor. And that's where something like this aluminum hinge stand comes in really handy. And of course, I'll link all this stuff up down below. Most of it, if not all of it, comes from Sitechi. First of all, this thing looks amazing, and it works for both horizontal and vertical viewing, depending on what you're doing. If you're typing, maybe you want it vertical. And if you're watching some media or something, like YouTube videos, maybe you want it horizontal. One of the best things about this stand is that it folds. So if you're not using it all the time, it doesn't have to sit there taking up a bunch of space. You can fold it and kind of store it out of the way. Also, there's a couple of movable hinges on here, so you can really dial in the perfect viewing angle. And I do want to mention that it's compatible with most cases, including the official iPad keyboard case. So you can have this setup as like your main desk setup, for instance, and then just grab your iPad with that Apple keyboard and head out the door to the coffee shop. So whether you're FaceTiming, typing, watching a video, or whatever it is, this is a great stand. And I have to say, I have no complaints using it so far. It seems really solid, really sturdy. I like the color, I like the style. So there's nothing for me to harp on for this particular stand. All right, if you're gonna be really serious about having an iPad-only setup, the second thing that you need is a serious keyboard, like this slim aluminum keyboard from Sitechi. First of all, are you sensing a pattern? Like everything in this setup matches. It's gonna go together really well with the stand and everything else that I'm about to talk about. And that's not a bad thing, it looks really good. So this is a Mac layout keyboard, and it's wireless, but you charge it with USB-C. So this is all good so far. I also like that you can pair it with four different devices and then switch between those seamlessly. So it looks really great, and I love that it has that number pad over there. It's got all the keys across the top for like some shortcuts that you would ever want. So I do love all the features. I do love the looks. I love that it's got the number pad over on the right. That's great as well. But you're probably wondering, how does it type? Because that's kind of the main thing with a keyboard, right? Well, actually, the typing is so-so for me. The keys are a little bit mushy, but not unbearable. Like, you can definitely enjoy it. Like with any keyboard, you gotta get used to it. And I can't go any further here without mentioning the last video that I just made on a mechanical wireless keyboard that works with iPads and Macs. So check that out, I'll link it up down below. So we're building this iPad-only setup. It only makes sense if we're trying to make it as professional as possible to include a mouse, because with iPadOS, we finally got mouse support, although it's not really how a lot of people would have envisioned it being. It's an accessibility feature and you get kind of a weird cursor, but still, it's very usable. So in this setup, we're using the Sitechi M1 wireless mouse, which is only like $30, really affordable. I gotta hand it to Sitechi and his mouse because it looks really cool. I like the looks here. And of course, you got that aluminum body that really matches all the other components of this setup. So if you're trying to make everything look really good and match, this is great. Aside from having a really sleek profile, one of the great things is that it works just as well for left-handed users as it does for right-handed users. And you know, unlike Apple's Magic Mouse, it doesn't have a weird charging situation with the cord sticking out of the bottom. It actually comes out the nose. So how does this mouse actually work? I've really enjoyed using it, actually. It's very easy to pair. It paired itself automatically, as did the keyboard. The buttons are nice and clicky, and I really love, I mean like love, love, the scroll wheel. I just love how it feels when you click and scroll it. So the next thing that you need if you're taking your iPad only setup very seriously is a serious charger. So for charging, we've got a 75-watt dual USB-C travel charger. So what's cool here, aside from matching everything visually, is that you can use it at your desk. And again, if you need to pack up and head out on a trip or something, you can also easily stow it away in your luggage or your bag and hit the road. The main reason why you would want to use something like this in the first place is that it consolidates all of your adapters for your iPad Pro into one sleek solution. So for the ports, you've got two USB-Cs, like I mentioned. One is a 60 watt and one is an 18 watt. So you wanna be careful what you're plugging into which. And then you've also got two old school USB type A's. So for instance, you could be charging your MacBook Pro and your iPad simultaneously, or your iPad and your iPhone simultaneously. So how does it work? Well, it works about like you would expect. There's not a lot to say here other than it looks really great doing what it does and matching the rest of the setup. And by the way, just helping you stay a little bit more organized and less cluttered. Now the iPad Pro in its current iteration, we're using the 2018 version in this video, but it only has one port, a USB-C port, which is great. It's USB-C, but it doesn't have to stay limited to just that one port. With Satechi's 4-port aluminum hub, you'll actually get a USB-C with power delivery, a 4K 30Hz HDMI display port, and I know this will make some people very happy, a 3.5mm headphone jack. So this accessory is in direct competition with some of the things we've covered here before, like the HyperDrive port, which is very similar to this, but also has an SD card reader. So how does it work? I would say it fits very snugly. I'm not worried about it going anywhere, and I like the looks. I just wish that somebody would give us two USB-C ports. Maybe that's impossible with the iPad. Maybe that's why nobody has done that yet. And I would appreciate the SD card for the next version. Now, I also want to mention the thing that everything is sitting on, which is a desk mat from Satechi. It's an eco-friendly leather, which I take it means non-leather desk mat. And there's just something about using a desk mat that kind of reorganizes your brain. It helps you declutter, it helps you get organized, get focused, I feel like, and also just makes your setup pop a little bit. Aside from just protecting your desk or surface from all the scratchy metal stuff that might be sitting on top. Basically, mostly, it just looks good and just helps your setup feel a little bit less mundane. All right, for part two, we're gonna talk about actually using this setup. What it's like, how it works, is it any good? And we're really gonna compare it to just using Apple's official keyboard and nothing else with the iPad. So when it comes to that monitor, the first thing that I wanna talk about is the viewing angle. Because one thing that bothers me about using iPads in general is just that it's on your desk or surface or wherever you find yourself typing, and you gotta like crane your neck down a little bit to see what you're doing and to operate. And I much prefer having the iPad raised up a bit like this stand does. In fact, I wish that somebody would make a stand that looked really good like this, but was even a little bit higher. But definitely though, I do like using the stand better, this Satechi stand right here, better than just using everything all attached and down on the desk. Next, let's talk about the keyboard, and more specifically, what it's like using this very big, very full-featured, full-size keyboard with those number keys over on the right, all the shortcuts. It's just a drastic change from the little mini compact, still nice, official Apple keyboard case. Using this kind of a keyboard with this full feature array and full size really makes a difference in your mind. When you look at the iPad and you look down and you see this big keyboard, it just feels like a more robust setup. And it is, actually, because you do get more keys and functions than you would otherwise with just a really portable keyboard. Now, the typing experience is a bit of a toss-up for me. A lot of people complain about the keyboard on Apple's official keyboard case. It doesn't have the key travel that some people like. It doesn't have backlighting, whatever. It has some flaws, but I almost like typing on that better than the Satechi keyboard. I say almost though, because it's not definitive. Maybe I'm getting too used to the mechanical keyboards now, and this one's really soft and quiet, which some people are going to love. So if that's you, you're really gonna like this. But if you want some punchy feedback, then maybe you do want to look at something that's more mechanical, or even Apple's Magic Keyboard. A big question for people as iPadOS starts to roll out here is using a mouse actually a game changer when it comes to the iPad? And I gotta tell you, it's a little bit yes and a little bit no. In some ways, but in some ways, I do really like it because it feels like more of a laid-back, desktop-like experience. You can kind of sit back in your chair, and just have your hand on the mouse and scroll around, and it's nice. And you do get that dot on your screen, which isn't like a huge distraction. I know why it's there, because it's under accessibility. I think Apple's sort of testing the water and see if people like this, if they use it, and whether they'll make it a non-accessibility feature and kind of give it more of a full featured feel and look. And in fact, if you guys want to see a video dedicated to using the iPad with a mouse and all the ins and outs, let me know. Leave me a comment. Let's focus on that charger a little bit next. Like, is it really necessary for a setup like this? And I would tell you, it's not necessary, but it's really nice. It's super convenient. So you plug in this 75 watt charger into the wall, and then you plug in the USB-C to USB-C for your iPad Pro, and you get that charging. And then you've got three other ports to charge some other stuff with. And yeah, this is really convenient. It's a space saver. You're like, charging, that seems boring. But honestly, it's a big upgrade. Now, what about that hub? Like, do you really need a hub with the iPad Pro? Isn't it all about portability and like getting away with as little accessories as possible when you squeak out the door and you're going on like a photo shoot or whatever? You're just trying to be mobile. Do you need a hub like this? Well, the answer is, if you do any creative or just professional work, I think you are going to want these extra ports. Whether you're giving a presentation to somebody at work and you gotta plug into like projector or the TV, or if you do just want your headphones, or if you want to be able to do these things at the same time. Not that you would do a projector with headphones. I don't know, I'm just spitballing here. But for me, having that USB-C still be available, and then having at least the USB-A for some older accessories, and you can convert that too to something else. Yeah, it is very useful if you plan on doing more than just web surfing. Now here's an interesting question. If I could only upgrade one thing in this setup, like to go from just the iPad with the Apple keyboard plus one thing, what would it be out of this setup? And I actually can't answer that directly because you can't just go with a stand, because then you don't have a keyboard or a mouse, right? So honestly, the bare minimum here, I think, is get the stand, get the keyboard or a keyboard, and the mouse or a mouse. Because you need those three things. And if you get those three things, it is a big difference in how you use your iPad. Now, the big question of the day is, and that's why we're ending it here, would I rather use this setup or a setup like this where it's really built out and it's like desktop class versus just the broken down, and I don't mean broken down like broken down truck, I mean like just minimal iPad with the official Apple keyboard. Which one would I choose and prefer? That's tough. If I'm going all in on my iPad, I think I prefer a more built out setup like this, a pro setup. But there's nothing wrong with just the minimal Apple iPad setup, because I love that too. There's something about, even if you have a big desk, just setting down this minimal slab of glass and a keyboard and getting to work. That's amazing. I don't want to underplay how cool that is. But I really see the appeal, is what I'm saying, of going all in with some accessories to make this feel more like a desktop replacement. All right, so that's it for this video. Let me know what you think. Let me know what other accessories you guys might want to add to this or replace down in the comments. Don't forget, you can subscribe to our other channels, The After Party and our Clips channel. And you can also find us on Twitter and Instagram at Daily Tech, spelled Daily T-E-K-K, in those places. And I'll catch you in the next video. Later.